remembering the way he acted and how he made us feel, and that big smile he would always have at every game. And it hurts. He'll be here. He might not be here in flesh, but he'll definitely be here in spirit.
And when I look at the Facebook post about Shannon, he seemed like a really good guy. Everyone seemed to love him. Can you imagine, like, who would even do something like this?
Whoever it is now, I pray that they come forward and just to get yourself comfortable, because the family is definitely mourning for this. It's kind of hard. The team is hurting, his mom, his family is hurting. We just need answers, baby. Everybody wants answers, because you don't understand why. You understand why.
And then if you want to pass the mic to Rob, I'll talk to you for a bit as well. Rob, if you could say a spell with four in the
morning. Rob Moore. That's from R-O-B. That's from M-O-O-R-E.
So, Rob, what kind of guy is Shannon?
Loving. Loyal. Good-hearted. Open-minded. Trustworthy. Always be there for you, no matter what. This football thing was our sanity. It kept us away from the life that we used to live. Besides our bills, what we did, besides you know, cutting hair, something we wanted to do. I can't understand why
somebody would want to do something like this. But this doesn't make sense, it doesn't add up. Shannon changed his life solidly.
I was right there with him. We put it together, you know. But I know for a fact that he didn't deserve it.
When you look at these fields, what do you think about Shannon?
Person. I always play ball with bro. I said, little bro, I need you to go get me that ball back. still without him. I'm definitely gonna hold him down. I made a lot of promises. Football that I didn't keep. You know, some championships and really making it, you know what I mean? Made a lot of promises. I'm definitely gonna do this for him. I ain't gonna be able to do it alone. Really. I got a whole bunch of generals behind me. I'm definitely gonna do this for him.
And when you say that, what is that what you're talking about? What you want to do for him?
We made it there last year. We just ain't finished. So we just coming back to take the championship this year. That's the only way. We're gonna take it this year for sure. No questions about that. Man, damn. He know that. It's crazy he'd have been a part of it. I don't even want to say like would have been a part of it because you know what? He is a part of it. He's gonna be out there with us. Here with us now. I know that. So I don't stop him. That ain't his thing. My boy doesn't want me to smile. You know what I mean? I know where it is. But you know, I got it.
And you were telling me this field was the last field we played on?
Yeah. Our last season last year. Actually was our first year. And we ended up doing no good. You know, going to championship. You know, we lost in the championship game. And that was our, honestly, to be honest with you, all the years we didn't play together, that probably was our best year. You know? Actually making it to the championship. So now it's just time to go back with him. He'll be on the sideline with us, whether we home or away. And he's just going to take it this year. He's definitely going to do it for him.
And this year, you're going to wear Shannon's jersey.
Yeah.
Why are you going to do that?
It's not. I should say it wasn't, you know, my idea, but the relationship we had, whether it be on or off the field, but when it came to the field, it was my ace. You know? People around us, people on the team, they know that. No matter what team we played for, whether it be the Bullets, whether it be the Rhinos, whether it be the Giants, it was my ace anyway. Thanks to Lightning, Maryland, no matter, I'm going anywhere in football. That's what he did.
And Rob, when you're saying that both of you overcame a lot of things, what was it that you had to overcome?
We overcame from just, we made some bad choices growing up. Living a lifestyle that we're trying to change in the community today. And over the last 8 years, football has been so good. Balance. And that's what kept us going. So outside of our kids, and you do get that little free time for yourself, football is what kept us out, you know, out of trouble. And slowly but surely, just maturing, you realize that that back and forth lifestyle over there wasn't worth it. And I think the difference that we did, you know, and we love to do, that's how we stay out of trouble.
How many kids does Shannon have? I understand 3 daughters and a son. Am I missing?
Yeah. I mean, action said all I can say. That's all you got. Like, in any situation in life, actions speak louder than words. And if you knew Shannon, you knew Shannon was a father. You know what I mean? A real father. No matter, like, from women to men to whoever. You knew Shannon, you knew he was a father, he was about his kids, and that's just what that was. He just put them first. He was really on the team. He was more of a father to the kids. He didn't have dads. Like, remember the one time him and Kevin actually got into it, you know, that he had to pretty much put up in the pool for him. And after that, that's the best part. I mean, like,
role model, you know, and like I said,
the whole, everything as far as from start, from raising your children the right way, to helping anybody in the community, it's like, good-hearted, man, it's just, somebody that will help anybody, if this don't add up and make any sense to somebody we want to be, something like this to him. And me, honestly, like, I need answers, man. I need all answers, man. Like, we, somebody's conscience to deal with them, and hopefully they come out and see it. Or anybody that needs anything that can lead up to anything, to step up to something. Step up and say something. We're trying to change the community. So retaliation is not an option, you know?
And Rob, if you could hand the mic back to Javon for a second. You were telling me on the phone earlier that you were going to retire Shannon's number. Why are you going to do that? Why do you do that?
The reason why is the person, the type of person he was, you don't get too many sins. Every time I ask him the ball, or, I mean, even the simple things, help hold on the field, or help out the winning guys, he never took me home. Never took me home. Never backed up, never had an excuse. I say he was a good guy for this. I mean, and football-wise, he was a monster. Everybody knows that somebody was a monster. And at the age of 35, he still had it. I mean, I just feel like after this year, I couldn't see nobody else in there. I'm not even going to say just me. It's a lot of people on our team that don't want to see anybody else in number 4. I mean, that man deserves for that number to be retired, so in his remembrance, we all came to it. We won it Bob the way he deserved it, because like I said, Bob was actually, out of all the players, he's one of the closest guys to Sean. So it's just, the end of all the frustration is, I don't even know the word to say, but yeah, you just deserve your first number to be retired. Just can't see anybody else.
And then if I could just maybe get a quick shot of you two guys walking across the field. I'm gonna go over that way, and then once I sit up there, I'll lead you over here and start walking towards my direction.